Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on how to have SwiftUI in your UIKit project. You heard that right, SwiftUI elements in UIKit, and of course with the help of DuckUI. So without further ado, let's jump right into today's session. Okay, everybody, this is how DuckUI looks like, and you can take a look at it at github.com/rebeloper/DuckUI. And if you are following along with this tutorial series, you will see that DuckUI is evolving quite fast. And let me just see where we left off. So if we take a look at the pod spec log, and just open it up, let's say with text edit, we are having a DuckUI with version 0.1.46. I don't know if that is visible there, but that's how we are using our pod right now. And if you take a look at today's version on the pod spec on the GitHub, it is 0.1.53. So a lot of releases have been made, a lot of changes, hopefully not breaking changes for you at this time, but make sure that you always update to the latest version. And if something breaks during these tutorials, yeah, you can take a look at the source code and maybe change some things. I try to be as consistent as possible and not break anything, of course, because this is version 0. Breaking changes could happen, and most probably there will be some, but not all. So take that into consideration when you see version 1, and that should be a stable version for you to test it out. Now, that being said, let me just show you how you can update your current project. So let's go to the root folder of your project. Okay, there we go. And this is just if you are using SwiftUI, the DuckUI in your brand new project. So you're not downloading this or cloning this later down in the future from my GitHub repository. So you need to update. And this is how you do it. So you open up terminal and you type in CD. So let's end the space and let's navigate to our project's root folder. And type in pod update, and that will update all of the pod files in your project. Okay, and because inside our pod file, and let me just open that up again, let me just open this with Xcode, so I'm just going to drag that in. So because DuckUI doesn't have any limitations, so not limiting to a certain version, it will fetch the latest version. So let's see if it does that. Yeah, it's going to take a little bit of time, but while we are doing this, let me just explain that today we are going to talk about stacks. Yeah, I should have started this tutorial by teasing you that we are going to talk about stacks. So there we go, DuckUI 1.0.1.53. okay, and we are done with the update. Okay, so let's go back to our root view controller, and as you can see, we have some basic label DuckUI here, but let me just go and do the occasional, or rather yet, let me just say kind of needed stuff when you update. I don't really know why this is needed, but we should go to product and clean our build folder, and once it is cleaned, hit command B or just build your project, so we can grab the latest version of the pods. I believe this should be automatic, but for some reason I keep getting crashes because it can't find the new functions that I have already added in the DuckUI, the latest version. Okay, so today we are going to talk about stacks, and you kind of saw in the previous video that we are using a vertical stack here. Okay, so let me just go ahead and create a, let's say, a new label. So there we go, hello DuckUI label 2, and let's just copy and paste all of this here like to. And let's just build and run and see how this vertical stack lays out all of this. Okay, and then we are going to build out a brand new one. Okay, let's just wait for that. And as you can see here, we have our hello DuckUI, and down below here we have our next one. So let me just change this and build and run again. And basically, why is that? We're underlying DuckUI here. We have a UIStackView, and it's set to fill its containers. So here we have, if we would have added a debug, so let's add a debug too. So dot debug and dot debug. So you can see how this is all aligned. And basically it is filling up all of the view that it's given to. And the container is set to have with the safe areas. So yeah, if you don't know what I'm talking about, safe areas, go ahead and take a look at the previous video. So it is filling everything up. So I don't really like this. So this has the hello DuckUI has this large frame, and the next one is just this one. So what I usually do here, just to show you, we are going to talk about this later on. We are going to add a spacer here. Okay. And let's hit command R again, and that will bump up or push up basically these two here. Yeah, and that is how awesome it is. Okay, so I told you that this is a vertical stack. If we wanted to change this to a horizontal stack, that is pretty easy. Let's just change this single letter here, so DH stack. And yeah, that is how it basically grabs the intrinsic content size of the label and uses it to fill out that stack view. Okay, now that we have that, and you can see how basic vertical and horizontal stack works, let's just create one out of scratch and take a deeper look at it. So let's see here. I will just grab all of these and add them up here, because why not? Because we can. And that is the power of chaining in DuckUI. So let's just delete all of these. Okay. And just so you know, debug releases, so returns a UI view. So if you want to style this label down here in the container, or where we add our layout, well, basically you can't use styles that have UI label, like let's say the text, let's change the text. So if you want to change the style of this label, you basically can't, because debug returns a UI view, and yeah, UI views don't have, let's say, text alignment properties or something like that. But this is fine, and we are going to talk about styling in a later video. So let's just go ahead and create some stacks from scratch. So first of all, let's grab our container, and yeah, in the previous video I have talked about the view controllers and how you can set it up and what this container basically is. And if you type in D and you just add an underscore there, and you can see these four types of stacks, and as you can see they are just simple UI stack views that you can use. And we already used a V stack and an H stack. Let's just a simple ones, and let's just use let's say a V stack with all of the properties there. So first of all, we have a list of views, then a spacing, alignment, and distribution. So let's just talk about all of these by creating this example. So in the views, I will just add hello DuckUI label and hello DuckUI label too. Okay, and yeah, let me just add some returns here, because why not? It looks really awesome. Now about the spacing, basically those are the spacings between the elements of your stack. And I will add in here 10 so we can visualize this. Alignment. So if you, basically those are UI stack views alignments, and if you add in here a dot, you can see that it's center, fill, first baseline, and if you add it in here, you can take a look at the definition. If you jump to the definition, these are all provided by Apple. So I will just skip this here because alignment, you should use center, well, basically 90% of the time, and or maybe fill. We have that set to fill by default because it really plays out not with the fill distribution. But yeah, I would just use fill for now and just delete that. We are not going to cover a lot of that. So next up is a distribution. And distribution, let's just add in here a dot, and you can see the five distributions that the UI stack you can have: equal centering, equal spacing, fill, which is the default mode for our stacks in DuckUI, fill equally, fill proportionally. Go ahead and take a look at all of the definitions. Basically, I will just basically show you most probably in these tutorials the fill and the fill equally, or maybe equal centering, we will see, but go ahead and play with those. And for now, let's just use fill, and while we are at it, we can simply delete it because that is the default value. So yeah, and the same goes for horizontal stacks. So let's just go ahead and build and run and see how this looks. Well, it should look quite the same, or rather yet, let's just add in here a spacer so we can see. Well, it's kind of better to do that. Oh, I need a comma here because spacing is added to the list of, well, parameters of the stack method. Okay, and right off the bat, you can see that here we have a spacing of 10. And yeah, if we would have added any other element, we would have some other spacings. Now, how cool is that? Okay, now let's just do this for the horizontal stack, just so you can see that. And next up, we are going to use another power of these stacks, and that is that we can, and basically we should, in most more complex layouts, we can use a stack within a stack. So let's go ahead and let's do that. So let's add in here back to a VStack, and let's see, I will just add in here a divider, and we are going to talk about dividers later in the tutorials, but for now let's just use a vertical divider here and let it be of type, let's see, let's have the normal one. Okay, so let's just build and run and see how that looks like. And after the divider, it's a little bit down from the safe area layout guide. I don't know if you can realize this, but it's there. Okay, so now that we have that, let's add a horizontal stack. So what I like to do is, again, let's grab our container because, yeah, this returns a UI stack view, and it needs to be added to some sort of view, and that is the container. So the underscore h stack, and yeah, let's just use the one with the all of the arguments, and let's just delete these so we can get only the spacing, and let's have here like 20 so we have a lot of spacing, and there we go. Nice. Okay, so let's move all of these three, maybe, or let's just move all of these two up. So what you want to use here, and it's really awesome, is Command Alt and square braces, and it is just going to jump up. If you want to jump down, you just use the other one. So yeah, real awesome. Let's add the comma here because the H stack is an element of the V stack. And what else do I want to put at here? We are going to use a spacer too, because I want to push them to the left. Okay, let's see. Let's see what do we have here. Okay, build has succeeded. And yeah, that's what we have expected. Now, if you want to push everything to the right, then of course we should add the spacer, again, Command Alt and the square brackets on between those two labels. Okay, let's hit Command R again and see how that looks. Really, really nice. And while we are at it, let's just add in here, let's see, an alignment, or rather yet, let's just jump into our definition and grab the distribution. So we are going to set the distribution. As you can see, it's also already the fill as default. And now let's add our distribution here to be, let's say, equal, fill equally. Let's see, fill equally. Okay, and hit return. Rather yet, Command R, sorry about that. Command R is how we run this. So this is how it is filled equally. And I don't know if you can realize this, but this is kind of, and let's just delete some of this text, okay? So you can see with the debug that it is filling the width of the page in three parts, okay? So you can see that's that. So we are not constraining to the intrinsic content size of the label. Now, if we go and select fill, then we would. So let's go back to the default value, see how that looks. Okay, we have talked about a little bit about dividers and spacers, but we will talk about that later down in the tutorial series. Now, I hope you enjoyed this one with stacks, and that is basically it. You can build out very, very complex layouts. Well, 90% of the layouts that you could encounter in UI will be or could be made with these kind of stacks. And I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next one, we are going to talk about frames, width, and heights. So if you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video about frames, width, and height, where we will dive deep into more DuckUI awesomeness. So I will see you in the next one.